Okay, you can see the Jupyter notebook, right?
Yeah, I have a Jupyter notebook.
No, no, I'm saying you can see the Jupyter notebook on my screen, right?
Yes, 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 yes.
Okay.
I can visit.
Okay, so let's start with Pandas then. So basically, Pandas is an open source library which is built on top of NumPy. Okay. It is usually used for fast analysis. Okay, there are functions in Pandas using which you can analyze your data well. So this will be basically used to clean your data, okay, prepare your data for analysis. Another very important feature that Pandas has is it has an inbuilt visualization feature, okay, which we'll be using later.
Visualization is like a matplotlib.
Yeah, somewhat like.
Okay.
So the first topic that we'll be seeing here is series. Now, series is very similar to your NumPy arrays. Okay, the difference here is in NumPy array, you had different data which had indexes which was not explicitly written. We knew that the index would start from 0, correct? 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. It was not explicitly mentioned that these are the indexes of the of your data. Here in series, you will explicitly write the index as well. So this is my data for this particular data, this is the index. You will have to mention that. Okay. So
first,
can you please comment? Sure. So see, series here, the series is present in Pandas. It is very similar to your NumPy array. Okay. But the difference is in NumPy arrays, you had indexes by default. You didn't have to mention it. Or you couldn't see the index directly. You can access your data by index, but you couldn't see the index directly. In series, you will have the indexes written along with the data. This is in theory. We'll see how to write it in practical. Okay?
Okay.
So let's import NumPy. And Pandas. Is it visible to us?
Yes.
Okay. Once you've imported, there are various ways in which you can create a series. The first way which we'll see is through a list. Okay. So we create a list. I'm naming it tables. You can name it anything. One more list. Okay. Now there is a function present in Pandas called series to create the series. Shift tab inside these brackets, you will see the definition of the function.
Sorry, can you come once again?
Yes, so inside the brackets of the series function, if you press shift and tab together, you will see the definition of the function or the signature of the function over here.
Okay.
So here you can see that these are the arguments or parameters that your function has. Okay. The first one is your data. The second is your index. Okay. So we'll be passing the same entry over here. And for index, I'll use the first list that I've created for label. This is equal to, by the way, it looks like the minus symbol over here. This is equal to. Okay. Now, if I execute this, this is what a series looks like. These are your data and these are your indexes. So for data 10, the index is A, for data 20, the index is B, and for 30, the index is C.
So we can take it as that we need to create a series.
Not necessarily. If you don't give index, by default, it takes 0, 1, 2.
If that is the case, it will be like the list number, right?
No. So here, if I just have one list for my data, I don't have another list for my index, then I'll create a series like this. Also, just for your reference, I wrote data and index. You don't have to pass those keywords every time. So when I create using my data, by default, the indexes will be 0, 1, 2, like in NumPy arrays. But here, unlike NumPy arrays, the indexes can be seen. Okay. So your series will always look like this. First column would be your index and the second column would be your data. You're using series is a function. Whenever you have a function, you use round brackets to call it. Yes.
Hello, ma'am. Can you please allow me to record?
It's getting recorded, Venkatesh. I'll send you the recording right after this session.
Okay.
Now execute that as well. It says labels is not, check the spelling of labels. Are you getting some error? No, it's not mandatory, but I would be using NumPy, so that's why I included that.
Okay. So here the labels are like ABC, these are the values, right?
Yeah.
When you assign data equals my data, does that refer to this or this?
No, it refers to the list called my data. I've mentioned this is my data, so I'm saying The data would be the entries present in my data list. The index would be the entries present in this labels list. You can name it anything.
Correct. Okay. Interchange.
Yeah.
So it's trying to understand.
Yes. So when you interchange, now my data is actually your index. Okay. And labels is your data.
Okay. What is shortcut for inserting an insert?
There would be this insert, right? Insert. There is a shortcut where
excuse me, are you writing somewhere?
I'm sorry?
Are you writing in the Jupyter notebook?
No, I was just clarifying everybody's doubt right now.
Okay. What I thought is that day what happened when Avanti was explaining the Jupyter notebook is now visual for me.
Okay.
So that's why I thought you were writing into Jupyter notebook.
No, not yet. However, you can see the screen, right?
Yes, I'm able to see.
Okay. So this was creating a series using a list. Now we create a series using NumPy array. Okay. So first of all, I'll have to create an array. This is how you create it, right? This array function. And here you can pass any list. So let's say I'll pass the same my data. So if it's print array, this would be a NumPy array.
Hello.
Yeah.
For this, one more. Labels equal to, we have quoted in single quotation, ABC.
Correct.
For my data, we have used an not quoted.
That's because, see, my data has numbers or integers in it, whereas labels has string values or characters. Characters cannot be written without inverted commas.
Okay. So, labels is just a variable, right?
Yeah, it's just a variable and it need not always be string. You can also pass numbers over here.
Okay.
It's just some data. You can use any data.
Mm-hmm. Can I add some comments here?
Yeah, sure.
Is it a hash?
Yeah, hash. Here's a comment. Venkatesh, there's some noise coming from your end, so I'm keeping you on mute. Whenever you have to speak, you can unmute yourself and speak.
Okay.
So we have created the NumPy array. Now using this NumPy array, we'll be creating our series. So again, the same function called series. And just pass this array over here. Okay. So since I'm just passing the data, I'm not passing labels. So by default, the index would be 0, 1, 2, and so on. However, you can pass index values over here by passing any list. So here you're creating it using a list, here you're creating it using array. Now when you created this array is of integer 32. That is why the data type is also of integer 32. However, that will not make a difference in your series.
What is
the value? So this D type is basically the data type of your values present in your series. Hmm. So it's an integer. Whether it's a 32 bit or 64, it doesn't really affect your.
That's fine. But what is the basis of that one? Why is it coming
in like? Depends on what values your compiler is taking.
Interpreter is taking.
It could be 32 or 64 bit. So no, in a, on a higher level, you see it as integers. On a lower level, it could be 32 or 64. Okay. So this was the second way of creating a series using NumPy arrays. The third way of creating a series is using dictionary. So in dictionary, you have the key value pairs, right? You can mention the keys as your data or keys as your index and values as your data or values as your index. Okay. By default, your values would be your data and the keys would be your index. So let's create a dictionary first. So now if you have to create your series based on this dictionary, again the same function, just pass this dictionary. So now as you can see, the keys are your index and values are your data.
We can have multiple values for a key. Although in your...
So see, multiple values for a key means a nested dictionary. See, for one key you'll have one value. Now you can have a value as a dictionary if you want. That entire dictionary will be taken as one data and will be printed here.
So for dictionary use.
Yes. Also, if maybe I misunderstood your question, do you mean you can have same keys twice?
If I say name, yeah, so then the key name, yeah, is real. Okay. And I'll say all of our names, I have to write. How should I write?
So in that case, you can either write it as a tuple or a list or another dictionary. Yeah. So that tuple or list or the dictionary that you put here will come here as it is.
Go like this or
yes. No, it will take it as one element.
Then it will be called d of 0, key with the particular thing will come up.
D of 0, so when you have a dictionary, dictionaries don't have indexes. If you have to refer to a particular value, you refer to it using the key.
So, call the first element, how will I call that?
If you have to call the first element, you will say d of the key.
D of the particular value.
Then it gives you the value. There is no indexing in dictionary. You refer to the values using the key. Okay. So there are a few things that you have to remember about a dictionary. You cannot have duplicate keys in your dictionary. It won't throw an error, but it will only take the latest one into consideration. Okay, this is the first thing. The second thing is, all the keys present in your dictionary should be of immutable data type. That means it could be a string, it could be numbers, or it could be a tuple. You cannot have a list or a dictionary as a key. However, you can have a list or a dictionary as a value. Okay.
And one more.
Yeah,
what is the difference between tuple and list?
So tuples are immutable data structures. Lists, you cannot change it. Lists are mutable.
That is. Same notation.
No. Tuple is written inside, it's not visible, it's mentioned inside the round bracket. List is in square bracket.
So the append function will not work for
No.
So when I give multiple values.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it takes as the entire element, right? It will not iterate.
So when the output comes, it gives a square bracket here.
Because that is one element which you have passed as a list. So it takes the entire list as the value.
So as he said, like if we are passing a list inside the first this one, the key, mm-hmm. if we want to access the first index of that particular first element of the particular list.
Mm-hmm.
So we call key of one of like that.
Yeah, you can do that. But not inside a CD. So see, if I mention it as a list. So this entire list comes as the data for key 1.
Uh-huh.
You cannot iterate through this using CD.
Take this call that. You can build manifestation.
You can. So right, while creating the CDs, you have to use the entire value.
Uh-huh.
Now while calling it, you can do that, which we have not covered yet, how to call a particular value from a CD. Once you call it, then if it's a list, you can iterate through it using indexes. Okay, so now I'm going to create two CDs and we see different arithmetic operations on them. Instead of creating lists separately, I'm passing it directly over here. Instead of creating a variable, I'm directly passing the list. All of a sudden, I don't remember the states anymore. You can create this one another line as well. I'm creating it in the same.
So this becomes a data on like a data column or
data index. So this is data and this is index. The first value that you pass is the data. The second value that you pass is your index.
So something for column.
Column is not for CD. That's for data frame. That is different. That is also in Pandas, but once we cover CD, then we know that. So I'm changing the index of data of the second CD. This is my series 1 and this is my series 2. Done. Now, if you have to access a particular element of or particular data of your series, you access it using the index. So let's say series 1 of. So this gives you the data corresponding to this index. Same way that you access elements from a NumPy array or from a list or any data structure. These are, after all, your indexes.
This is case-sensitive, right? Whatever putting the commas.
Yeah, so this is the value that you have provided. So it should be as it is.
But the keywords are not case-sensitive.
No, yeah. Even keywords are case-sensitive. Python is a case-sensitive language. All the keywords except for true, false, and none are in lowercase. True, false, and none starts with uppercase. The first letter is uppercase. Other than that, all the other keywords are in lowercase. Series and all are not keywords, which you see here, right? These are not keywords. These are functions. Function name.
That is also lowercase.
Yeah. If it is defined this way, it has to be used this way. Okay, so you access values based on the index. Now, if I try to add both the series, so if I say series 1 plus series 2, what this operation does is it will try to match the values present for the same index. So it will try to add the values for Mumbai and Mumbai, okay, for Delhi and Delhi, for Bangalore and Bangalore. But then in the second series, Bangalore is not present, right? So wherever it is present, it will add them. Wherever it's not present, it will mark it as null. So that NaN is basically null.
And it arranges in the random order?
No, not necessarily. It's just some random order.
Hello.
Yeah, Venkatesh.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Actually, we are having two data types of 64. When we add it, it becomes float 64. Is there any concern how it is casting?
No. See, when you perform this addition operation, it converts it to float.
Right, so both are in error.
I'm sorry, your voice is breaking. Can you please repeat? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, yeah.
Is it audible?
Yeah, it's audible now.
Yeah, actually, my question is...
Yeah.
Data
actually, hello?
I'm not visible. Correctly. Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
We have a two data type of integer, right?
Correct.
And when we perform addition, then why it is changes to float?
Okay, so whenever you perform addition on two series, it returns a float value.
Okay.
That is something that this addition operation does.
That is with respect to series, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, similarly, if you perform some other operation, let's say series.
If we do not have, I just added third series, okay, let's assume that value, Mumbai, is available in series 1 and 2. It's not there in third. Still, we will get NaN, right? It won't add 1 and 2.
So you are adding series 1, series 2 and series 3 with?
Yeah. And let's assume that BL Bangalore is available in 1 and 2, series 1 and 2. It is not there in series 3. I'm
just going to copy the same one. Okay, so wherever it couldn't find a match in all the series, it will not throw an error, it will just return none over
there. Even though the values are very clear in two series, still let us consider the name.
Yes.
So with this addition, I mean, when you have two lists and if you are performing tests, it will append. But when you do the series, it will be like adding the elements.
Yes. In series, it will add based on the indexes.
So I'm passing it. Passing in the alphabet or string inside that one. In that case, what happens?
So in that case, it would be a problem. Okay, because let's say this is okay, then it will throw you an error.
So it won't happen. You cannot append to C.
No.
In part series, in place of MAA, it is using some other name. That MAA will become 0, MAA?
Yes. Okay, so whenever you perform operations on series, it tries to matches. It tries to match the value based on indexes. Yeah.
So to three series.
Yeah.
So only one column will make sure that it's a series present.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere else,
you have different values.
Yeah. Your third value is different here. So Mumbai is here, first two.
Okay. No, but then you do have Mumbai somewhere, right?
Correct. So it will add up.
Yes, it will add up. Based on values that you have for that index Mumbai in all the three series, it will add up those values. So the first two series, it will add 1 and 1. Okay. For the last series, it will add 4. So it will be 6 for Mumbai.
Thank you. Values, okay, this is 1. So your value, minus 1. So it is not a point. Okay. It's not common here.
Yeah, Hyderabad, you don't have anyone else. It's so small.
Okay. These two are added, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So, need not be present in all the columns.
Yeah. Okay. So, this was about series. Okay. Now, using the series, we'll be working on something known as data frames.
It can be said like a two-dimensional array or a series.
So we'll see now that data frames is nothing but a combination of different series. Okay, so as a definition, you can mention that data frame is basically a bunch of series sharing the same index. Okay, so now for preparation of data, I'm going to import this tandem. This is just for the preparation of data. As in, I'm going to create some data which is randomly generated. So I am importing this rand n function from this random module that's into NumPy.
But we have already, you have already imported NumPy, right? At
any yeah.
So the random should be there.
It is. It should be there. But I'm doing this so that I can directly use random. Otherwise, I'll have to say numpy.random.random every time I use the function. If you import it this way, you can directly use random. You don't have to say numpy.random every time. Okay, so did Avantik cover this for you, how to import? Okay, so see, whenever you have to import a module, you directly import it like this. Import, name of the module you want to import, and this is just providing some alias to it. However, there would be, when you have a module, module is basically a combination of different classes and functions. So if you have to, let's say you are importing a module which has hundreds of functions, and you want to use just one particular function out of it. So in order to use that, you have to say numpy dot the function name. Okay. Mm. Now numpy is basically a package, not a module. Now within that package, you have multiple modules. Each module has multiple functions. So in order to use a function, you'll have to say numpy dot module name dot function name. Correct? So in this case, I had to use just this one particular function called randn, which was present in this module called random. Okay, so this is another way of importing. Instead of every time saying numpy.random.random, I'm importing it in this way, but I'm saying from this module, import this function. It's not importing this entire random module for me. It's only importing this randn function. So now I can directly use randn rather than saying numpy.random.random. Okay, you have to import in order to use it. These are all inbuilt. These are all present in Python. But in order to use it, you have to import them.
But we already import the library already. So
NumPy, yes.
From random, import random. That is what you're talking about, right?
No, you, whenever, so you've imported a library or a module or anything that you import, if you have to use the content present inside it, the syntax is the module name.
Ma'am, your voice is not proper, clear.
Is it? Is it fine now?
No, ma'am. My voice is not clear.
Just a minute.
Some extra sounds are coming in between while you're speaking.
Okay.
I don't think it's with internet. I don't think so.
Maybe because people here are speaking, so you could hear those voices as well. It could be because of that verification.
No. Actually, that is okay. But the thing is that there is a, there is a some mismatch. Why is it so? No, your voice is not clear. What you are speaking is not clear.
Okay, is it still not clear or now is it fine?
Yes. Now just you spoke, no, that time also I got the same kind of thing.
Your internet connection is fine.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Mine also the same as your speed.
Okay, just let me know whenever you're not able to hear, I'll repeat again.
No, ma'am. Actually, now you also speak. No, that time also the sound is, fluctuating. I don't know why it is happening.
Yeah, I can do that. Venkatesh, should I give you a call and then you can see the screen via the Zoom meeting? As for my voice, you can hear it from the call.
We'll continue. If again it will happen, we'll go with the call, ma'am.
Sure, sure.
Hello?
Yeah, that's fine.
So here, random is a module.
Random is a function.
Random is a function.
Random is a module. Correct.
Number is package.
Yeah.
The syntax is already imported. In the alias PD, you already have NumPy. Yeah. So like NP, correct? So that will
you can say np.random from np.random import random or numpy.random.
From np.random.
Says no module named np. Did you execute that statement?
Yes.